Hey, welcome back to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. I'm Bob, and today we're going to discuss reamers. So let's get started. So I have two different types of reamers. You have a reamer set, and I have what they call a fast reamer. And the difference between these two reamers, this is half inch to three quarter reamer. And this one is a fast reamer. You can see the flutes are tighter together. And you can tell the fast reamer not only by the flutes, but the fast reamer has this stopper on the end. This is what they call a standard reamer, okay? And if I show you these together, you can see the difference in the flutes. The spacing of the flutes. Fast reamer is obviously faster to cut through metal and to achieve your reamer. They also call these car reamers. They ream through basically almost any type of steel or metal. You can see that the standard reamer does not have that stopper that the fast reamer has, and that's how you can see the difference between the two reamers. These reamers also have the three cuts on the shank so they don't spin in your drill. So we're going to test these reamers, but before I test them, I have a set here that I'm just going to go over with you. These are U.S. made. These are Viking, Norseman reamers. You can buy them in a case. They go from 3/8 of an inch all the way up to 3/4. So you have a 3/8, a 1/2 inch, 5/8, and 3/4. And the sizes I'm giving to you is the maximum that they can ream. So these are USA made, high speed. They have the three flutes. They're designed to ream structural steel plates on cars, trucks, frames, rails, bridges, used to enlarge formed or drilled holes. Left-hand spiral, right-to-hand cut. These shanks, drill surfaces are about 5.5 inches long on the 3/4. Obviously, as you go smaller down to a 3/8, this is probably about 3 inches long overall. So let's give it a whirl and let's see what we get. So I pre-drilled a 1/2 inch hole for the reamer for this demonstration. You can see it comes through the other side. This is what the manufacturer recommends, starting at 1/2 inch for a 3/4 inch reamer. I'm going to now put a little lubricant on the bit. It's always good to use lubricant. Let your reamers and bits last a lot longer. Give it life. So you don't have to buy another one for a while. This is my first time reaming this, so there might get stuck a little bit. I don't know. We're gonna see how this goes. I'm running this battery drill in the first speed only, and I'm gonna try it in the second speed also. So let's test it out now. Let's see how we do. Yeah, baby, that is one cool bit. This is the fast reamer. You can see it has that stopper and the swirls are tighter together. And that's what you don't want to do. All right, I'm going to bring the camera around so you can see the hole that I've reamed out. So as you can see here, I reamed this hole out to the 3/4. I started that hole with a pre-drilled hole at 1/2 inch, and I brought it a little larger than 3/4, as you can see there. I twisted it a little bit. You also saw the drill bit bind in there and fly out of my hands. That's one thing you have to be cautious about, because that does hurt. It hurts the wrist. But that's our video and our demonstration on this 1/2 inch to 3/4 fast reamer. There you go. Subscribe, like, comment. Visit us at albanycountyfasteners.com for 50,000 SKUs right off the rack, ready to ship. We look forward to seeing you in our next video.